Hey there, everyone. Matt Roberts for RealGate TV. It sure has been a busy week in the City of Angels. Burlesque opened, and I think every mo in Southern California went to see it. Meanwhile, the Grammys hosted their second annual nomination concert with Katy Perry, Bruno Mars, LL Cool J, Miranda Lambert, and some Justin kid. We'll get to that, but first, Reese Witherspoon, one of Hollywood's most bankable stars, got her star on the Walk of Fame this week.
This resolution on behalf of the people of Los Angeles, congratulating Reese Witherspoon on this extraordinary moment, an angel in the city of angels and a star among stars.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. How incredibly overwhelming. But after 20 years of working in this business as an actor, I realized what making movies is. And for me, it is, I'm going to get emotional, but it is an achievement of being part of an incredible community of people who are the best at what they do. Whether they are our wonderful writers who give us our words or our directors who craft these amazing stories. All of the crew members, from the electricians to the grips, right? To the hairstylists, to the costume designers, everyone who collaborates to bring joy and light and a little bit of entertainment into our lives, to create that for us. It is really so much more than I ever imagined it would be. So for me, this is a moment about being accepted into a community that I so love and really cherish working in. A couple of months ago, I was actually training for a movie at a circus school down here, and my kids and I were walking on Hollywood Boulevard going to have some dinner, and I realized I had never really explained to them what the Hollywood Walk of Fame was. And I said, you guys, do you know what this is? You know, each one of the stars represents an entertainer who has achieved a significant amount of things. And they said, well, Mom, Ava and Dickie said, Mom, do you have a star? And I said, no, I don't. They haven't asked me. It's, you know, it takes a lot of work, and you know, it's a big honor that they bestow upon you. And they said, well, they better hurry up while you're still alive. You can still enjoy it. And everyone out there who sees this, if you're a fan or you want to come hang out with me while I'm still alive, you'll know where to find me. I'll be right here at Hollywood and Vine. Thank you so much.
Reese is near the top of the list of highest paid actresses, earning an estimated $20 million a film. The ceremony was part of a launch of How Do You Know, co-starring Paul Rudd and Owen Wilson, which opens December 17th.
Over, so I'm a little too pissed off to just say hello.
I think I screwed up.
Not from my perspective.
Taxi?
No, I just have to figure out where I'm going.
Let me ask you something. How do you know when you're in love? Anyone?
I got a way. I figure I'm in love with somebody when I wear a condom with the other girls.
Holy crap, I'm in love.
What sort of trouble are you in, George?
Currently unemployed. I'll soon run out of money. And
I'm the target of a federal investigation.
You're a real chick magnet, aren't you?
Another top-earning actress, Jennifer Lopez, was out in front of the media this week at a press conference where Denzel Washington introduced her as the new spokeswoman for the Boys and Girls Club of America.
Ladies and gentlemen, the newest and first female national spokesperson for the Boys and Girls Clubs of America, ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Lopez.
This is a very exciting day for me. It really is. Joining Denzel as the national spokesperson for the Boys and Girls Clubs of America. And it is especially meaningful to become the first female spokesperson during this 20th anniversary of the name change to the Boys and Girls Clubs of America. Boys and girls! It's crazy when you can remember something from 20 years ago, but we're not gonna dwell on that, okay. You know, over this Thanksgiving week, I was sitting outside and reflecting on how fast this year had passed. You know, watching your kids get bigger, my babies, and how much they've grown in a year, and thinking about what a journey this has been, you know, for me from the Bronx, from the Kips Bay Boys and Girls Club, the 6th train to Manhattan, and being here now with you guys today. When I was that impressionable little girl from the Bronx, running to Kips Bay Boys and Girls Club to sing and dance and perform for the first time in front of an audience, I didn't know what was in store for me then, but I knew that in the Boys and Girls Club I had a place to go, a place to find me and who I was, to be me, and to be with people that I trusted, who were good to me, who cared about me, and who I cared for, and to be with other kids who were also finding themselves and exploring their dreams and aspirations. While I was trying to learn and explore who I was, the Boys and Girls Club was there like a family away from home to support me. The club encouraged us to believe in ourselves and to be great. You know, the other day I was asked in an interview if I missed the Bronx, and I said no. And the journalist looked all surprised, and I said, you know, I never missed the Bronx, because it's always like right here. Right here, all those memories, doesn't matter where I wake up, in what part of the world, where I'm working, what I'm doing, in a big house that I live in now. I'm just always right there in the Bronx, right there. I never miss the Bronx because it's always with me. I guess, you know, I'm always gonna be Jenny from the block, and I'm proud to say that I'll always be that girl from the Kips Bay Boys and Girls Club. And to say that the Boys and Girls Club will be right here for you, always. Join us in helping kids be great and attain great futures. Thank you.
To the right, please!
On your right! On your right, please! Jennifer, to your right!
To the right, please!
Keep coming, right?
Jennifer, right here, please!
Give us a round!
Are your sons members of the club?
Come through, back.
That press conference was at LA Live, where last night the Grammy Foundation hosted the second annual nomination concert.
Anyway, here's a California girl who's been having a very big year. It could be a real contender. Ladies and gentlemen, Katy Perry!
Katy Perry sang California Girls, but it was Teenage Dream that was nominated for Best Female Pop Vocal. Perry was also nominated for Album of the Year, where she competes with Arcade Fire, Eminem, Lady Antebellum, and Lady Gaga. Perry nabbed 4 nominations in all.
So you feeling some Grammy love right now?
Hell yes. Excuse me, sorry, CBS. Thank you so much.
So, I mean, is it a Teenage Dream? Like, do you feel, like, incredible? Do you feel amazing?
It's amazing. It's like no other award show, because I feel like you're being recognized by your peers, and there's so many fantastic performers and artists that could be in this category. So when they nominate you, it's kind of like a win. But if I win, I won't say that.
Now on to that Justin kid we were talking about. Justin Bieber, who stole the show at the American Music Awards last month with 4 awards for 4 nominations, landed 2 Grammy nominations, Best New Artist and Best Pop Vocal Album. The 16-year-old appeared by satellite from London, where he is touring right now.
How does it feel to be a Grammy nominee?
Wow, it feels amazing. I can't believe I'm in this position. I want to thank all my fans, everybody. I want to thank, you know, the board. I want to thank, I don't know what to say.
Well, I got a question. I mean, what are you doing up so late? No, I'm kidding. You're a superstar now. How does it feel?
It feels good. I don't think of myself as a superstar. I think of myself as just a regular person living my dream, you know?
Bruno Mars, who was also on hand last night, was nominated for 7 Grammys, including Record of the Year, Nothing on You.
Oh, her eyes make the stars look like they're not shining. Her hair falls perfectly without her trying. She's so beautiful, and I tell her every day. Yeah, I know.
I mean, I knew my music is just pretty, you know, incredible. So this is not really
Y'all getting this?
I don't know what to say, man. You know, it's been a hell of a year for all of us, and the fact that we do record these songs not too far from here in this little shabby studio, and here we are, with Grammy nominations is a little surreal. So we'll just think.
A couple of ladies, Gaga and Antebellum, along with Jay-Z, got 6 nominations, but it was Eminem with 10 nominations who stole the evening, at least for now. The Grammys air February 13, 2011 from Los Angeles, and we'll see you there. From the red carpets of Hollywood, this is Matthew Roberts for Real Gay TV.
Now I know we said things, did things that we didn't mean, and we fall back into the same patterns, same routine, but your temper's just as bad as mine is. You're the same as me, when it comes to love, you're just as blinded. Baby, please come back, it wasn't you, baby, it was me. Maybe our relationship isn't as crazy as it seems. Maybe that's what happens when a tornado meets a volcano. I'ma tie it to the bed and set this house on fire.
I'm just gonna stand there and watch me burn. But that's alright, because I like the way it hurts. Just gonna stand there and hear me cry. But that's alright, because I love the way you lie. I love the way you lie. I love the way you lie.